الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. قال عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه: حاسبوا أنفسكم قبل أن تحاسبوا، ووزنوا أعمالكم قبل أن توزنوا. عمر رضي الله عنه, he said, take account of yourself before account is taken for you. Weigh your deeds before your deeds are weighed for you. He's talking about a principle that we have, or an etiquette that we have in our religion, known as muhasaba. Muhasaba to nafs, self-accountability, to hold yourself accountable. As one of the scholars said, فَالْيَوْمْ عَمَلٌ بِلَا حِسَابٌ وَالْغَدًا حِسَابٌ بِلَا عَمَلٌ. Today there is actions without any accountability, and tomorrow there is accountability with no actions. Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, مُحَاسَبَةُ النَّفْسِ لَهَا ثَلَاثَةُ أَرْكَانٍ. Self-accountability, it has three pillars. Inshallah ta'ala, we'll cover one this morning, and inshallah ta'ala, tomorrow and the following day, we'll cover the other. He said, number one, أن تقايس بين نعمتك وجنايتك, is to compare the blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you, compare that to the sins that you commit. Take the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you and compare that to your ingratitude that you have shown Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that blessing or those blessings by way of your disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you did that, you would realize that every blessing you have, you don't deserve. جاء رجل إلى إبراهيم بن أدهم أحد العلماء في الزمن الماضي فقال يا شيخ إن نفسي دعتني إلى معصية الله فأعذني فأعذني. فقال إبراهيم يا هذا إذا دعتك نفسك إلى معصية الله فعصيه ولا بأس لكني إليك خمسة شروط. Man came to one of the scholars of the past by the name of Ibrahim ibn Adham, and he said, my soul calls me to be disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this soul is known in Islam as al-nafsu al-ammaratu bisu, the soul that is constantly calling the individual to commit haram. He said, my soul constantly calls me to be disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَعِذْنِي, give me some maw'idha, give me some admonition, admonish me, advise me so I can stop. Ibrahim ibn Adham, he said, the next time your soul calls you to be disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَعَصِيهِ وَلَا بَتْسِ, disobey him. Go ahead, do it. Go ahead, be disobedient to Allah. Don't worry about it. He said, but before you do that, I have five conditions for you. If you can fulfill these five conditions, then go ahead and be disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The man said, فَهَتْهَا, give him here. Ibrahim, he said, إِذَا أَرَدْتَ أَن تَعْسِ اللَّهِ فَاخْتَبِ فِي مَكَانٍ لَا يَرَكَ اللَّهُ فِيهِ. That if you want to be disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then just go somewhere where Allah can't see you. فَاخْتَبِ فِي مَكَانٍ لَا يَرَكَ اللَّهُ فِيهِ. Go find some remote corner somewhere and be disobedient to Allah. Find a place where He can't see you. And the man says, Subhanallah, وَأَيْنَ أَذْهَبْ وَلَا يُرَانِيَ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. Where can I go where Allah won't see me? He said, فَهَاتِ الثَّانِيَ, give me the second one. He said, إِذَا أَرَدْتَ أَن تَعْسِ اللَّهِ فَلَا تَسْكُنْ فَوْقَ أَرْضِ. If you want to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then don't live on His earth. He said, فَأَيْنَ أَذْهَبْ وَالْأَرْضْ كُلُّهَا لِلَّهِ جَلَ وَعَلَى. فَقَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ لَا تَسْتَحْيِ أَن تَعْسِ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ تَسْكُنْ فَوْقَ أَرْضِ. أَمَا تَسْتَحْيِ. He said, where am I going to go? The whole earth belongs to Allah. He said, well, aren't you the least bit embarrassed that you would disobey Allah and then turn around and live on His earth?
The next time your soul calls you to be disobedient to Allah, then don't live on his earth. Same thing we tell our children. We tell our children, if you're going to live in my home, then you're going to obey my rules, right? If you're going to live on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's earth, you're going to obey his law, subhanahu wa ta'ala. That if you want to disobey Allah, then don't live on his earth. He said, well, where am I going to live? Though all of the earth belongs to Allah. He said, well, aren't you the least bit embarrassed? Don't you have any shyness that you would disobey Allah and then turn around and live on his earth? He said, "Hadd al-thalitha." Give me the third. He said, "Idha aradta an ta'si Allah, fala ta'kul min rizqihi." فَقَالَ الرَّجُلُ فَكَيْفَ أَعِيشُ فَقَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ لَا تَسْتَحِي أَن تَعْصِي اللَّهَ ثُمَّ تَأْكُلْ مِنْ رِزْقِهِ. He said, the next time you decide to be disobedient to Allah, then don't eat from his provision. Don't eat from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's provision. The man said, well, then how am I going to live if I don't eat? Ibrahim said, well, aren't you the least bit embarrassed that you disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and then turn around and eat from his provision? Turn around and eat. Because if someone was to disobey us and we had to feed them, we would refuse to feed them if in fact they disobeyed us. وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى. And to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala belongs the highest similitude. The same thing happened with Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, with Mistah ibn Uthal, who was engaging in the kalam that was being spread about his wife Aisha that she committed adultery. And Abu Bakr said, wallahi, I will never give you sadaqah again. You harmed my daughter. You lied on my daughter. I will never give you sadaqah again. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the verse, وَلِيَعْفُ وَلِيَصْفَحُ أَلَا تُحِبُّ أَن يَغْفِرُ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ أَلَا تُحِبُّ أَن يَغْفِرُ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورُ رَحِيمٌ. Said Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the verse about that incident. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, pardon and overlook. Wouldn't you want Allah to forgive you? Showing you that if you want forgiveness from Allah, then you have to extend that to other people. If you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you, then you have to also be forgiving towards other people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, forgive and overlook. Don't you want Allah to forgive and overlook your faults and your mistakes? And indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ghafoor rahim, is forgiving and merciful. But just look at that. The moment someone disobeys us, we refuse to do anything good for them. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَا أَحَدٌ أَصْبِرُ أَصْبِرُ مِنَ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى مِمَّا يَسْمَعُ مِنْ أَذَى الْخَلْقِ فَإِنَّهُمْ يَكُولُونَ يَجْعَلُوا لَهُ الْوَلِدْ وَيَجْعَلُوا لَهُ النِدْ وَيُعَافِيَهُمْ وَيَرْزُقُهُمْ. That there is none more patient than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the harm that he hears from his creation. They attribute to him a son, they attribute to him partners, and he still gives them good health and still provides for them, subhanAllah. Even after you attribute to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a son, even after you attribute to him partners, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala still turns around and gives you good health and gives you, wakes you up in every morning and still provides for you, even though you don't deserve it. He says, so if you want to disobey Allah, then don't eat from his food. The man said, well, how am I going to live? He said, well, don't you feel the least bit embarrassed to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and then turn around and eat from his food? He said, number four, إِذَا عَصَيْتَ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ جَاءَتْكَ الْمَلَائِكَ يَسُقُونَكَ إِلَى النَّارِ فَلَا تَذْهَبْ مَعَهُمْ. He said that the next time that you decide that you want to be disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when the angels come to take your soul to the hellfire, then don't go with them. He said, كَيْفَ لَا أَذْهَبْ مَعَهُمْ فَهُمْ يَسُقُونَنِي سَوْقَ. He said, how am I going to refuse not to go with them when they're just going to drag me to the hellfire and I have no control over that? Then how could you turn around and still disobey Allah knowing that this is going to be your end result? The next time you decide to be disobedient to Allah and the angels come to take your soul to the hellfire, then don't go with them. He said, and lastly, he said, إِذَا عَصَيْتَ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ تَقْرَأَ الْأَصَّحِيفَ بَيْنَ يَدَيْكَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَأَنْكِرْ أَنْ كَدْ فَعَلْتَهَا. He said that if you decide that you want to be disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and your book is laid out in front of you, يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, and you read your sins, Right? As Allah will tell the servant, اقرأ كتابك كفى بنفسك اليوم عليك حسيبا. Read your book today. You are sufficient as a proof against your own soul. Read your book. When that book is laid out in front of you, 99 سجلة كل سجلة مد البصر. 99 scrolls will be brought out, each scroll as far as the eye can see. And Allah will command you to read your book. He said, when you read your book and you see all of your sins in your books, فَأَنْكِرَ أَنْكَدْ فَعَلْتَهَا, then just deny that you did it. Just say, it wasn't me, I didn't do it. The man said, how can I deny that? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kiramun katibun, He has noble scribes that write down everything and they don't disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They don't make mistakes. When the angels jot down what you do in your book, they don't make any mistakes. So this is, you know, number one from muhasabah to nafs is to compare the blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you to the sins that you commit, which is a direct indication that you are undeserving of the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you. You're undeserving of the house that you live in. You're undeserving of the eyes that you see with. You're undeserving of all of the ni'm, all of the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. Wallahu al-azim, nahnu muqassirun. We have so many shortcomings, wallahu al-azim, we should be embarrassed to enjoy the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. But this is part of muhasabah. This is how you hold yourself accountable. You look at yourself and you say to yourself, I know I don't deserve this. I know I don't deserve this. And that is a whole nother chapter, and that is acknowledging in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you are not deserving of the things that He has given you. And this is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you more when you do this. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a'lam. So inshallah ta'ala, tomorrow we'll cover the other one, and then the following day we'll cover the third. Bi-ithnillahi ta'ala. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallama tasliman kathira. Allahumma ya muqallib al-qulub, thabbit qulubana ala deenik. Allahumma ya musarrif al-qulub, sarrif qulubana ila ta'atik. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وآخر دعوانا عن الحمد لله رب العالمين والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.